Hey guys, so crazy to see you here. We haven't talked in a good minute. You're probably like, Nicole, why do you have a YouTube channel but then not ever use it? And before it's because I was lazy, but now it's just because I'm unmotivated. But this video is really easy because I'm literally sitting on my floor. It's a chillax video, you feel me? So yeah, I have my little Hello Kitty mug. So cute. I have no idea what's in it. It's like this weird juice stuff. You're not gonna be able to see it. Oh my gosh. So yeah, we're here to do a little wisdom teeth video. Now, I'm gonna do a quick disclaimer, because if you don't do a video in 2020 and don't have any type of disclaimer, then it's literally gonna get demonetized and taken down within 30 seconds because someone will find a way to hate on it. So I'm not a dentist or orthodontist, or know anyone that is a dentist or orthodontist. I don't really like dentists or orthodontists. Nothing personal, just stop putting things in my mouth.
Well, when life gives you lemons.
So, take everything with a grain of salt because this is my personal experience. I hope you enjoy my personal experience and I hope you learn something from it. Sorry, that was the universe trying to tell me to calm down, Nicole, calm down. Do your own research. Doing your own researching and looking at different types of sources is always the best thing to do. So, but I hope this prepares you a little bit. I know, I probably should have done something like this. I didn't do anything like this, so. Yeah, a lot of people wanted to know my story, and I think I make all stories absolutely immaculate. So, who knows? Who knows? Just, I'm gonna try to make this as interesting as possible, so just keep listening, because if you, like, exit out, it'll make my watch time go lower, and then we're just not gonna be friends, you know? So, I made this video into 6 separate parts, and the parts will be in the description below, so it will have little timestamps, and then that way you can just skip to the certain part of the video if you don't want to listen to my annoying self, like, for 20 minutes straight, you know? Okay, so I'm gonna explain the parts of the video now, so you kind of get an idea of what we're gonna talk about. Okay, cool. Also, I talk really fast, but there is a setting on here where you can slow down a video, so if you think I talk too fast, press that button. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. So the first part is gonna be the preparation. What I did to prepare myself for the surgery. 2, during the procedure. 3, after the procedure. 4, how to take care of your teeth. Some little tips and tricks I'm gonna give to you. 5, what to eat and what not to eat. And 6, my absolutely immaculately hilarious videos. I'm already a funny person, you know? As you can tell by the first 2 minutes and 38 seconds of this video. It's absolutely immaculate, you know? So just imagine me, but on drugs. It was like, astronomical. So yeah, that's the majority of it. You feel? Okay. So yeah, timestamps in description. You want to skip? Go ahead. Okay. But number one, preparation. Okay. So to prepare, I did nothing. Literally nothing at all. Like 2 weeks ago, I posted on my story, wish me good luck. I'm gonna get my wisdom teeth taken out. Quirky. And then my friend was like, yo, her name's Joelle. Absolutely love her. Sweetest person ever. She's like, bro, I got mine out like a week ago. And I was like, oh my gosh, fill me in. So then she sent me a little paragraph about what was crack-a-lackin', and that was pretty much it. Literally, like, you know the feeling when, like, you care because it's like your body, so you, like, don't want to die, right? But you're also like, these procedures happen like every single day, so I'm not really gonna stress that much. That was kind of the vibe I was trying to throw into the universe. I don't really know if anyone caught it, but like that's what I was doing. Now we're gonna move on to the second part. Like when I entered the building, right? That's when things got really spicy. Okay, so I just got there and then I had to wait 40 minutes because my sweet dentist, I had 2 orthodontists. I don't really know. When I say dentist and orthodontist, I mean the same thing. Some people might take that a little bit too seriously and be like,
they're completely two different occupations.
I'm sorry, man, but they are like, they deal with teeth. So just know that they're the same people. But I had 2 people work on mine. One was a girl, one was a guy. I don't know their names, they didn't tell me their names, but they were both so nice, like literally so nice. So I got there, but I had to wait a little bit for my appointment because she got stuck in traffic and she lived down the hill. So that was all right. Got me my heart rate a little bit up because I was just sitting there in the lobby with my mask on, like Then before they set you down, like in the room where they actually do the procedure, they bring me into this little x-ray room, and this probably is gonna happen for every single one of you. Oh, hold on. This is the dentist I went to somewhere on the screen. That's the building I went to. Everyone's experience is gonna be different for everyone. Like, don't think that your experience is gonna be the same exact for mine, because it's literally not. We're all individual people. So, but for the x-ray part, I'm pretty sure everyone has to do it. Because the x-ray part, they, like, need to see, like, where your wisdom teeth exactly are, like, in your mouth, because, like, it's different for, like, they're always gonna be in the general area, right? But there's sometimes they're a little bit different. And so, yeah, they just had to do that, see where mine exactly were. Also, some tips for the x-ray, don't wear any metal. Please don't. Like, necklaces, earrings, take that all out. Otherwise, I don't know what it will do, but just, it's not gonna, I don't know what it will do, but it's just not for it. Also, don't chew gum, because one time my friend got an x-ray when he had gum in his mouth, and it literally liquefied the gum. Doesn't sound appetizing whatsoever. That sounds absolutely disgusting, but still seems like a kind of a cool experience, but like, I don't really know. So yeah, don't do that. Yeah, then they're just gonna ask you a few questions while you're doing the x-ray. You're gonna go, yeah, yeah, no. Probably not while you're doing the x-ray, because you gotta keep your mouth still, because that's what the x-ray's on, but you get the point. Okay, so then after the x-ray, moving on to the next part, we go into like the actual procedure room where they're gonna do everything. So you just lay down, and then my lady, like, she was like the main person that like did everything. She was so nice. She was talking to me about like her family, and then like about how like COVID affected her and her family, and I was talking about a little bit how it affected mine. And yeah, she like, it just made me feel a lot better that she, because she was so friendly, so I didn't have to be so nervous and I could talk to someone, because my mom wasn't back there, because clearly, like, if they're gonna work on me, like, she can't just be in the corner like yeah, because she would definitely try to talk to me during the procedure. Like, I would be out of it, I wouldn't respond, but like, I know she tried to talk to me. But yeah, she had to go back in the lobby. So yeah, so that was really cool of her to talk to me. And so then while she was talking to me, she was getting all the stuff prepared. And so for this next part, if you've ever gotten blood drawn or put in any type of needle within your two like elbow creases, that's a body part. It has a name. I'm just gonna call it elbow creases, cause I don't know. But this part will be a little bit easier for you, because that's where they put the amnesia. I know for different dentists, it's like different, because I know some dentists, they take a needle and they put like it in your jaw somewhere, and a few other places do it differently. Like I said, I haven't done research about this stuff, but that's just what I've heard. And so she put the little needle, and honestly, you guys have that one friend where they're just a little bit too aggressive and they just like hate you all the time. Like, I don't really know, like, that's just their personality. They probably have a lot of brothers or something, and they just always take really everything aggressive. That's literally what it feels like. It feels like an aggressive pinch, and that's about it. Like, it didn't hurt at all. And I'm one of those people that's a little bit scared of needles. Like, it's not too bad for me, so it didn't really affect me that much, but I just take that into consideration, that there will be a needle going into your arm to put the amnesia like into your body. But don't worry, you literally cannot feel it go into your body. And also with the amnesia, they put an oxygen tube through your nose, so like you can breathe throughout the surgery, because you can't if they didn't put the oxygen tube. And you can feel the oxygen going into your nose, which that was kind of trippy. It literally just feels like someone blowing like in your face, but into your nose. And also, I know you're thinking this too, because I was like, do people ever wake up? Sorry, this is my bed, and so I need to do something when I'm talking. So, I was like, do people wake up during surgeries? Because I tripped out, because someone once told me in the 7th grade that 1 in every 3 people in a surgery wake up, and I was like, no.
No.
Wasn't for it. I was like, no. Okay, and here's what they told me. They said some people do wake up, but it's called a twilight sleep, so where you'll wake up, but you'll be so like under like the drug so much that you'll just be in and out of it, and most people don't even remember. But I actually remembered, but I'll get to that part in a second. But if you do wake up and you do remember what's going on, don't stress, because they numb your mouth. I don't remember like how they numb my mouth, because while you're like on the amnesia and stuff, it's like in your system for a little bit while after the procedure too, and it makes you forget a lot like about what's going on. And so I don't really remember how they like numb my jaw. Like, I'm trying to think of it. I think they do it after the procedure. I mean, I think they do it after they put in the amnesia like into your system, because it might hurt or something. That definitely makes a lot more sense. I've never thought of it that way. So yeah, they put the amnesia. So if you do wake up, don't stress. They numb your jaw, so you literally can't feel anything. From your like top lip down, you won't be able to feel anything. Well, clearly the rest of your body, from like this section, you can't feel anything. But so yeah, don't stress about that part. It's literally all good. So, now we're moving on, finally, to the second part of the video. It's already 10 minutes and we're only on the second part. Crazy. Okay, sorry if I talk a lot, but just remember, if you get bored, there's the timestamps. I promise you'll find something at least interesting in this video. So, during the procedure, I actually did wake up, and I actually have a good, really, really good memorization, and so I remember seeing them work on me, and I thought it was so trippy, because I was like, I didn't understand how people don't wake up and remember during the procedure. Like, picture this. So, you're watching the movie Alice in Wonderland, right? And then she falls into the hole, and you're like, oh my gosh, she knows she's in the hole, but there's so many rainbows going on. There was just so much going on. Like, I can see them, but they were so twisty, and there were so many colors. Like, it was so rainbowy and stuff, and it was so trippy. Like, it was like one big dream. Like, I know I keep saying a lot of like, compound words, like and or and like right now, but like, I don't know how to explain it. It was such a cool experience. Like, you're like,
oh, your voice up to be taken out. Calm down.
And I'm like, I know, Kyle. That's the audience's name now. Your guys' name is Kyle. But like, it was so trippy because it was, I don't know. It was so crazy. There was just like so many colors and I could see them and they were working on me, but like, it was so chill. Okay. And so yeah, that's pretty much all the procedure part. Like I said, I was out of it. I didn't feel anything while they were doing the procedure. Like literally nothing affected me. That's one of the reasons why I hate the dentist so much though, because I hate the feeling of my mouth being numb, because you literally feel like your lip is this big and I don't know why, and you're just like, like the whole time. And I just hate that feeling. Like it sucks so much. And so now it's time for after the procedure and how I felt. So, they've informed me before that some people, like, they'll wake up from the amnesia, like, bawling so hard, like, just, like, so many people, like World War VII is going on, and then some people will be hysterically laughing, and, I was bawling, one, because I'm sensitive, and two, because I, like, do this thing before where, like, I don't really care, like, before the procedure, I did not care whatsoever. But then like a minute before, I was like, yeah, what if I just start hysterically bawling because I scared myself so much? Like, I'm one of those people that gets nervous or something 30 seconds before, but other than that, I'll be completely chill. Like, I think my brain was like, oh my gosh, you're gonna go into this surgery right now, start crying because you're nervous. And it like didn't fully process that it already happened. And after you wake up, if you're like tired, it's gonna take you a little bit longer than other people to wake up. The procedure total only takes about between 30 and 40 minutes. Like, it's really short. It's not that big of a deal. Like I said, these types of things happen every single day, so don't stress. So yeah, I don't know how long it took me like to wake up because I didn't see the time before I actually took the amnesia. And I asked the dentist, the guy, like orthodontist before, I was like, in the movies, they like count down, so do I need to start counting down? He's like, I mean, you're gonna be out in a minute, so if you want to start counting down, you can. We don't require it. And I was like, interesting, because I swear, every single movie that requires them to go to the dentist, they're like, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Sorry, that reminded me of Hamilton. That's like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It's the 10 dual commandments. Okay, sorry, it's a really good bop. Really would recommend. Anyway, so yeah. I didn't start counting down. I literally don't even remember my last thought. I just was like, imagine me counting down. Like, I was out. So, I didn't die, though. I probably should not refer to so many, like, passing out things, because it's probably tripping a lot of you out. My apologies. After the procedure, I was, like, hysterically bawling. Like, it was over. But you can, like, when you're like, okay, you know when you're like super tired and you like, you're just closing your eyes and you can kind of, and you're like still kind of dreaming, but you can still hear people like in they're like talking in your dream. That's what it was like. Like everything was just pitch black, but I was still aware that I was awake and I could still hear people. And in the background, the orthodontist kept saying, Nicole, your procedure is over. But I was just like bawling because I was like so scared. So I was like, and then he's like, Nicole, you're all right. And I was like, like I just kept moaning, and I looked back and I was like, if I would have felt so like, the doctor must have been like, like he literally wants to look like the frick any Mike Wazowski meme ever. Just, I just feel so bad because I was making so many weird noises and I was crying. And then eventually they realized, like, they're like, is something mentally wrong with her? So then they brought my mother back. They're like, come. And then she started taking videos of me, and I eventually woke up because I realized my mom was there. So I was like, I guess I'll say hi. All of a sudden I wake up, I was like, and then she's like, and she was like laughing, and then I was like bawling, and then I saw her laughing, and I really like it when I make people laugh, so I started laughing. So I was like, so that's pretty much what happened for like the next 15 minutes after that. And then because you're really woozy, like, woo, that's a good band. So they brought in a wheelchair next to me so I didn't like trip after. You know, like every single movie where people are drunk, that's practically what you're gonna be like woo. But after crying, like, I just felt like my eyes were like so open to the world. I was like, I love everyone so much. So then I was just in the car. I was like, I'm gonna Snapchat me doing all of this. And all of these videos and clips and photos will be at the end of the video during section 6 funny videos. So yeah, all of that happened. I was like, I need to inform everyone how I'm feeling. And then my mom had to go get my medicine because they prescribe you Norco, which is very like high drug. Some people take opioids as well, like high dosage of a drug. I don't really know. It's very addictive though. And it, like, for most people, doesn't agree with your stomach, and it doesn't agree with my mom's, like, at all. So she didn't want me to have it, especially because it's so addictive. So what I do is I just take between 2 to 4, ibuprofen. And they also prescribed me another one. I don't know what it's called, but this one, it doesn't take away pain. It's just to help there not be an infection. So it kind of just helps clean out your mouth. So my mom went to Vons cause that's where my prescriptions come from. And so she picked that up. So I just chilled in the car for like 10 minutes. just got my wisdom teeth out check. I actually might've made that Snapchat, but we're not gonna talk about it. So yeah, I was just chilling in there, probably listening to Still Woozy. It was kind of a vibe, not gonna lie. So yeah, I was just chilling in there, and then I finally got home. My mom got me this, like, oh, and then when I got home, I ate a smoothie bowl, because you can't eat, I should have mentioned this earlier, my bad, but it's gonna be weird to edit, so I'm just gonna say it now. You can't eat 8 hours before your surgery. So my surgery was supposed to be at 9. It actually happened at like 9:50, I think. And so just stop eating at like midnight and you're good to go. But like if it's later in the afternoon at like 2, just make sure you don't eat 8 hours before or drink anything. You can't eat or drink anything for 8 hours before your procedure. And I asked why, and I find this so funny because some people throw up during the middle of the procedure. Like, can you imagine how awkward that would be? Like,
can you hand me the scalpel?
And then the patient's like, like, as they're sleeping, like, imagine the first person to do that while someone was getting worked on. I would have died laughing so hard. See, this is the things I find funny. It doesn't make sense. Like, literally someone throwing up while getting their wisdom teeth done, that sounds absolutely terrible. But it sounds, like, personally, if that was me, I'd be like, I am so sorry for you having to look at me while doing that. Like, that, no one needs to see that. So, yeah, that happened. So, that, it didn't happen to me, but that just sounds kind of really funny. So, yeah, please do not eat or drink anything during that time. So yeah, so after the procedure, I also had Gatorades at home, which I definitely think are really good because Gatorades have electrolytes in them, so they make sure that you stay really hydrated. And I'm a person that likes to, as you can tell, drink things like nonstop, and I really have to use the bathroom all the time, but no one asked for that, so I'm sorry I didn't put that. So it was really a struggle for me to not drink anything for those 8 hours. I was like, it's tragic. So yeah, so if that's difficult for you too, I feel you, man. I feel you on that one. So yeah, so as soon as I got home, I had a bunch of liquids, and as soon as you're done with the procedure, you can literally eat something if you want to. Like, you might not be able to feel anything, but you can eat stuff. So by the time I got home, I still really couldn't feel like my mouth or anything. So I waited like an hour to eat because I didn't want to like put stuff in my mouth and like not be able to know where it's going, because if it's like, if my neck is numb too, like, I'm just, it won't work. So I kind of was just chilling in bed. I was just kind of laying down, going on my phone, like just having something to distract me. And I didn't feel any pain afterwards either, because like your mouth is still numb. But at home, they give you gauze too. The gauze is really annoying. So like after the procedure, they have the gauze in your mouth, and you need to like replace it like every 30 minutes or so, because after the procedure it's gonna be bleeding like a lot. So if you don't like blood, that might be a problem as well. But there's gonna be a lot of blood. So you're gonna use these gauze. It's like little, I'd describe it as like cotton strips. It's kind of like a combination between cotton and toilet paper. It's just like these really thin strips, but they're just gonna go in the back of your mouth, like right here. And you just kind of gotta stick them back there. And so that way they collect all the blood. So that way, and you gotta make sure you keep them on there for a while, because like when you apply pressure to things like that are bleeding, it helps the bleeding stop. I don't know if that's just common sense, but I just feel like I watch a lot of movies and that's just what they say. So you gotta do that, but I absolutely despise gauze and things in my mouth. Like, that's why I despise the dentist so much. So I only did that for like an hour, but like, it's fine. Okay, so if you disagree, then that's really cool. And I just replaced it a few times within that hour, but then I'm like, I can feel my mouth now and I really need to eat because my 6 or 3 pound life, I need to eat and drink stuff like every 12 minutes, you know? So my mom made me a smoothie bowl, so that was so sweet of her. She also got me this plant. I don't know when she got it. I just remember she came home with it. And like I said, so if you're like, I wouldn't recommend doing any type of schoolwork or any type of work that's serious or important to you while doing this, because like I said, you're constantly forgetting things. Like I have a really good memorization. And today is currently Tuesday, and I got mine out on Friday. So it's been about 4 days, I think, right? Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Yeah, so it's been about 4 days since I've done it. So it's all really fresh in my mind. I might have forgotten a few things, which I really hope I didn't. If you do have any questions, please DM me on Instagram or comment them down below. I'm literally in quarantine and always on my phone. So, but if anyone asks, I'm also doing my history homework. So yeah, please just let me know. I love helping out people. That's why I'm making this video. Now I'm gonna explain to you how to take care of your teeth. Woo! I can already explain this part throughout like some of the video, but I'm gonna like do it again. So what you're gonna do is please, you can brush your teeth clearly the morning of your procedure, because clearly you're like, nothing's wrong with your mouth, so go ahead and brush your teeth. Make sure you got it nice and clean, okay? You're going to the dentist. I don't need to hear them complaining about you having cavities while they're doing your wisdom teeth too. Like, we don't need the honey bunny. I'm a very hygienic person, so like, I try to do this. Like, I swear, one time this dentist was like, you have a cavity. I almost bopped him in the head. Yeah, make sure you get it real clean, because the night of, you cannot put like anything, like you could try to brush your teeth the night of the surgery. Good luck with that. I didn't want to do that. Like anything going in my mouth besides like nutrition and food, I did not want to do that, so, or clearly medication. Like, it didn't seem like the vibe. Like, especially, like, I was terrified to, like, put a toothbrush back there. It just freaked me out. So, I didn't want to do that. So, I just proceeded to, like, brush my teeth clearly every single morning and night afterwards, though. Like, definitely do that, otherwise it's not going to be clean and we don't want that. I wouldn't really recommend it doing the day of after the procedure, because I don't want anything to hurt you, because no one wants to get hurt. So yeah, I don't recommend doing that. But you also can't use mouthwash for like the next week, 2 weeks. Just ask your dentist about that. He'll inform you about the specific dates. When you go to bed, make sure you use a towel like as your pillowcases, or just lay a towel on top of your pillowcases, because the bleeding's not gonna stop for like the next few days. Like, it's gonna, okay, clearly the first day, it's gonna be a lot more than the days after that, but also don't, like, stress that it's gonna be bad, because literally, like, it's in the back of your mouth, so you'll most of the time just swallow the blood, and also the mouth is the fastest healing organ in the body. Then you're gonna get blood on your pillow, but, like, don't stress over it. Don't be like, oh my gosh, I'm so weird, I got blood on my pillow. Bruh, it happens to everyone. Like, don't stress. Please, literally, anything that happens after your procedure, don't stress. It's probably happened to literally like every single person that's ever gotten their wisdom teeth taken out. Also, if people haven't gotten their wisdom teeth taken out, that also is a possibility. So also, this information could possibly not apply to you. And it's also just because some people naturally have bigger mouths than others, but my mouth has always been really small. Even when I had braces, I had to get an expander because my mouth wasn't big enough. It's still not big enough. So yeah. And I, like about a year ago, during I had really bad pain, in the back of my mouth from November and October, and that's how I knew that my wisdom teeth were coming in, but it wasn't like that big of a deal, and they didn't tell me I need to have my wisdom teeth out by a specific time. Like most people, they get their wisdom teeth out when they're like 20, 21, 22, but I just wanted to get it done and get it over with because one, we're in quarantine, so it's not like anyone's gonna see me while my mouth is still swollen or anything. I think the swelling went down a little bit. It's still really sore right here, so I can tell that it's like still swollen. So if I look a little bit bigger than I usually do, let's just blame it on that. My mom explained this story to me like 7 times about how when she got her wisdom teeth taken out, she was like 19 or 20. She got an infection because she ate rice and the rice got stuck in her mouth, and then she like started puking out yellow chunks. Oh, you're welcome for that story. I had to hear it 7 times. So if you got grossed out, times it by 7. So yeah, please make sure you're cleaning your mouth, taking your cleaning medication, and also instead of mouthwash, you will be replacing your mouthwash with salt water. I'm gonna do a little video tutorial on how to do that. Make sure you're just gonna swish around like 4 times. I just really tried to reenact me swishing out mouth. Sometimes I still think that the amnesia is still in my system because like my sentences, they do not make sense. So yeah, it's literally just gonna be the same thing as the mouthwash, but it's just not the mouthwash. Cool? Also, you're not gonna be able to use straws for like the next 2 weeks. Because if you do, I looked it up and it's gonna create this thing called dry mouth or something. I don't know, it's still like an infection. I'm assuming it has to do with your mouth being dry. I don't really know. It sounded really painful though. There was like a little description, but I don't remember it. But it just, any infection that comes from your mouth, that's like where all your food goes. And like, if your mouth has an infection, you're not gonna be able to taste your food correctly. And then what's just the point? What's the point, man? Number 5. Okay, what to eat and what not to eat. Smoothie bowls? Yes. Smoothies? No. Why? There's a difference, Nicole? Smoothies you use with a straw. Like I said, you can't use a straw. Also, don't put any type of granola in your smoothies. Like, you can put like bananas, I guess. But like any type of fruit that's really like hard to chew, like why would you put cantaloupe in a smoothie bowl? I don't know. But cantaloupe, it's real crunchy, you know? That's my favorite fruit. That's why I thought of it. Yeah, wouldn't recommend that. Also, you're not going to be able to move your mouth correctly for the next few days. Like, there's like certain facial expressions I can't do or are really painful to do, and it's literally been 4 days later. So your mouth is going to definitely take like a full week or a full like week and a half to heal. And the reason, how I felt, like I probably should have mentioned this earlier, but how I felt after the procedure, I wouldn't describe it as painful, but think of it as like, if you did a really hard workout and you may or may not have pulled something, and then just think of that soreness being in the back of your mouth. I just feel like soreness and pain are both really different things, so I just would definitely describe it as sore. But going back to what you can and can't eat, I just had chips and salsa. That's definitely been the easiest thing I've ever eaten, like, during this whole entire time. So the first day, I had, a smoothie bowl for, like, lunch because it was, like, later in the day once I got home. And then, I had the ice cream. And then for dinner, I had just a bowl of beans because my parents had burritos. They had burritos the next night, too. My mother has never made burritos at home in her entire life. So can someone explain to me why they had a burrito the night I got my, I don't know why, man, but just, that thought made me so mad. Like, out of your 14 years of living, I mean my 14 years, you've lived for longer than 14 years, but like why'd she have to choose that one? Why that day? What was so special about that day that you had to make burritos? So, if you're like me and are impatient and can't handle more than 2 days of eating soft foods, then sure, go for it. But just be careful, because it might really hurt. Definitely don't know from experience. Chips are really easy to eat. The front of your mouth isn't affected, right? So if you do, it's by the time it gets to your back of your mouth, you can just swallow. But most bigger things like hamburgers and like other things like beans and rice, use your molars, which are in the back of your mouth, and that's right next to where your little holes are for your teeth. That's where you chew the rest. So it's just, it's a lot harder, but like chips and stuff. So like if you wanted to have like Wheat Thins, the basil tomato kind, those are good. I haven't had those in a while, but those are good. So yeah, I definitely recommend like those, but anything, I don't really know, like almonds, things that have like shells that could or like apples. I just had one of those that I didn't eat it whole. I cut it up, but like that doesn't seem like it would work. It didn't work. I have had popcorn. That kind of scares me. I don't think I'm gonna do that for a while. But yeah, just, it's, the eating part's really personal. If you think you can handle something one day and can't handle it the next, and then if you like hurt yourself, don't get down on yourself for eating something, because like food's nutrition, and like if it's good for you, then eat it, but just take it at your own pace. I definitely know I got down on myself, be like, darn it, I shouldn't have done that. I brought so much pain among myself. But then I take a like Advil, I mean ibuprofen, they like work the same, but my mom just likes ibuprofen better, so she buys that one. And so then I'm all better, and I feel a little bit better about myself, but I'm still a little bit sad, so then I eat more ice cream, but then I'm lactose intolerant, so like it kind of just like doesn't really work out sometimes. So that's pretty much for the eating part. Now finally, I know we're actually at the end of this video. I'm gonna insert all my funny clips and videos.
Okay.